passive income.
Good morning to His Grace, our Panchayat, Namasami Kreji, brothers and sisters, welcome to our Holy Communion service. We will start on page 70 in a small liturgy book, Swalvan Ebbet. Asamana Bhagavan Hastadu Sahagavan Amen. O my brother, think of thyself and ask forgiveness, so that thou mayest obtain this before going out of the church, where the fierce sacrifice is offered on their own behalf in them. Do not separate thyself from the priest who prays and offers a sacrifice on thy behalf, in order that thou mayest not go out of the person they send out, but abide in the church, and listen to the word of the priest, and listen to him who asks for the listen behalf of thee and all sinners, that they will be compassed to them. O man, if thou desirest to receive forgiveness of thy sins, why dost thou welcome the church when ever is going and asking for mercy on thy behalf? And why art thou idle? At that time you let your mind wander from things to do. You who are seeking the seal of heaven departed with even Christ. But the church will dismiss thee and shut her door against thee, so that thou wilt never enter, because no stranger will be found in hell. When her bridegroom cometh, she shall open her doors, and his bride be at the bridegroom. But the stranger shall not be, because it is not given to him who hath seen a bridegroom that at his marriage sacrifices his body and his fellow forever. The Son of God had then endured in the world, which no one except for him hath done like him since the creation of the world. At his marriage, he hath ordained on the table before his guests his holy body and precious prayers and banquet, so that they may eat thereof, and so that he who believes in him may live forever. The meat and drink of our Lord Jesus Christ at his marriage. Blessed be our God who hath given us his holy body and precious blood for the forgiveness of sin, that he may live thereby forever. Glory be to him, world without end.
Amen.
A hymn of praise on the Sabbath of the Christian day, Sunday. You were named beloved, O blessed among women. You are the second chamber, for you were born the Holy of Holies, where the sins of the covenant contained the tangles which were written by the fingers of God have been kept. This you have made unto us, blessed at the altar, which is the first letter of the name of our Redeemer Jesus Christ, who became incarnate from you without change, became the mediator of the new covenant, and by the shedding of his blood, he purified the believers and the holy people. Pray to him for us, O Holy One.
O Holy Virgin Mary, pray for us.
We all magnify you, O Lord, and of the bearer of God, lifting up our eyes to you, we invoke you. Pray for us that we may find grace and mercy with him who is the lover of men. You are the tablet, or art which is covered all over with gold, which has been made of wood that never would perish. So we find for us the word of God who became man without separation and chain, even the holy and undefiled deity who is called evil the Father. He was announced to the pure woman without sin. He became like unto us at the might of his wisdom. He who was incarnate from you, even he who was spotless, mingled this divinity with us. Pray to him for us, O Holy One.
Holy Virgin Mary, pray for us.
You are the sanctuary of the travels around us this time, O God. The word was incarnate of you, O pure one without change. Have become the forgiver of our sins, and the observer of our transgressions. Pray to him for us, O Holy One.
Holy Virgin Mary, pray for us.
the manna, to bring up kingdom from heaven to give life to all the world. Pray for us, O Holy One.
Holy Virgin Mary, pray for us.
You are the world and candlestick and host of brilliant light at all times. Light from light, which had no beginning, verily God from verily God, was incarnate of the without change, and by his coming shed light upon us, upon those of us who were sitting in the shadow of death and said death, and he set our feet upon the path of peace. Beloved God of all evil's love, pray for us, O Holy One.
Holy Virgin Mary, pray for us.
You are the censer of God, because you carry the cause of the blessed fire, which he took from the sanctuary. He who forgives sin and destroys wickedness, he who is the word of God who became incarnate of you, and he who offered up to his Father in service, incense, and precious offerings, pray for us, O Holy One.
Holy Virgin Mary, pray for us.
You are the garden of delight, the garden of joy, just planted in the trees of the element, and was prepared for the sin before the world was created. And the great child was guarded by cherubim and seraphim, that will fashion up of a flame of fire. One of the seraphim visited her from heaven and said unto her in the sanctuary, "Blessed art thou among women, the Holy Spirit shall come upon thee, and the power of God shall overshadow thee. For he who dwelleth upon the cherubim shall become the light of all the world. Rejoice, O Mary, beautiful dove. You have borne for us the word of God, and you are a seed sent of power which has sprung up from the root of Jesse. Quaking for us, O Holy One.
Holy Virgin Mary, pray for us.
You are like unto the rod of Aaron, which shall be planted in the ground, and without watering bursts into blossom. In like manner, you, O bearer of Christ, did bring forth Christ, our God, in truth, without sin. He came and he ever us. Pray for us, O Holy One.
O Holy Virgin Mary, pray for us.
It is meet for you, O you who are full of grace, more than all saints, to pray on our behalf. You are greater than the high priest, and you are more honorable than the prophets. In you there is majesty of appearance, which is greater than the majesty of the seraphim and cherubim. Verily you are the glory of all race, and you are she who must make for life also. Pray thou then on behalf of our Lord and Redeemer of Jesus Christ, that he may confirm us in the right faith, that is to say faith in him, and that he may graciously bestow upon us his mercy and compassion, and may his abundant mercy forgive us all our sins, forever and ever. Amen. Pray for us, O Holy One.
O Holy Virgin Mary, pray for us.
Yeah.
Both now and ever, Lord, without end, amen. Yukertan lemindelin hatiadachinin yasisrelins and desileada. Please, Lord, to save me.
Oh, For he hath covered us and suffered us. He hath kept us and brought us nigh, receive us on himself, and undertaken our defense and strengthened us and brought us unto this hour. Let us therefore pray him that the Almighty Lord our God keep us in this holy day, and all the days of our lives and all peace.
Spot for the life of the world.
We now pray, beseech your guidance and goodness, O Lord of man. May thy face shine upon this prayer and upon this cup which we have set upon this spiritual ark of thine. Bless this prayer and hallow this cup and cleanse them both and change this prayer to become thy pure body and what is mingled in this cup to become thy precious blood. Let them be open for us all for healing and for the salvation of our soul and our body and our spirit. Thou art the King of us all, Christ our God, and to thee we set up high praise and glory and worship. With thy good heavenly Father, the Holy Spirit, the life giver, who is co-equal with thee, both now and ever, and world without end.
Amen. This is the order of our fathers, the apostles, let none keep in his heart wrath for revenge, envy or hatred towards his neighbor, towards any other body.
Blessed Archbishop Abbot Daniel, we beseech that God transcends length of days to you first, that with understanding they may rightly speak the word of faith in purity without spot, for that they are the defenders of the church. For the priests to seek that God may never take from them the spirit of priesthood, and they give them grace of zeal and fear of them unto the end, and accept their labor. For the deacons to seek that God may grant them to run upon the cause, and draw nigh unto Him in holiness, and remember their labor and their love. For the assistant deacons and anonymous and the singers, we beseech that God may grant them to perfect the diligence of their faith. For the widows and the bereaved, we beseech that God may hear their prayers and God save them from wanting in their hands the grace of the Holy Spirit and accept their labor. For the virgin, we beseech that God may grant them the form of virginity, and that they may be unto God sons and daughters, and that He may accept their labor. For those who suffer patiently, we beseech that God grant them to receive their reward through patience. For the lazy and the faithful, we beseech that God may grant their complete faith which they may keep in purity. For the tax command, we beseech that God may grant them a good portion and the washing of regeneration for the remission of sin, and seal them with the seal of the Holy Trinity. For the government of Trinidad and Tobago and of Ethiopia, may God vouchsafe them much peace in their days. For the rulers and those in authority, we beseech that God may grant them of His wisdom and His strength. For the whole world, we beseech that God should hasten His purpose and put into the mind of all and each to desire that which is good and expedient. For them that travel by sea and by air, by land, we beseech that God should guide them with a merciful right hand, and let them enter their home in safety and peace. For the hungry and the thirsty, we beseech that God should grant them their daily food. For the sad and the sorrowful, we beseech that God may give them perfect consolation. For the prisoners, we beseech that God may loosen them from their bonds. For the captives, we beseech that God may restore them to their country in peace. For those who are sent away, we beseech that God should grant them patience and good instruction, and give them complete reward for their labor. For the sick and the diseased, we beseech that God should heal them speedily and send upon them mercy and compassion. For those who have fallen asleep in this holy church, we beseech that God may vouchsafe them a place of rest. For those who have sinned, our fathers and our brothers, we beseech that God cherish not anger against them, but grant them rest and release from its wrath. For the rain, we beseech that God may send rain on the place that needed it. For the fruits of the earth, we beseech that God may grant to the earth for sowing and for harvest, and all of us who ask and beseech in prayer, may cover us with the spirit of peace, and give us grace and enlighten the eyes of our hearts. Let us draw nigh and ask God to accept our prayers according to His will.
Let us bless them for rise in the Holy Spirit, growing in His grace and understanding, glory in His name, and built upon the foundation of the prophets and the apostles. Let us draw nigh and ask the Lord our God to accept our prayer according to His will. Page 55 in the small to G and 29 of Exodus 118.
An acceptable sacrifice. Worship thee, Christ, and thy good heavenly Father, the Holy Spirit, the life giver, for thou didst come and saved us.
Amen.
Fidele mole abo el umen fescidus.
Sir, God.
For even hereunto were ye called, because Christ also suffered for us, leaving us an example, that we should follow his steps. Who did no sin, neither was guile found in his mouth? Who, when he was reviled, reviled not again? When he suffered, he threatened not, but committed himself to him that judgeth righteously. Who his own self bare our sins in his own body on the tree, that we, being dead to sin, should live unto righteousness, by whose stripes ye were healed. For ye were as sheep going astray, but are now returned unto the shepherd and bishop of your souls. Amen. O my virgin, love not the world, yet not the things that are in the world. The world passed away, but the love thereof, for all is passing.
Holy consubstantial Trinity, preserve our congregation, for thy holy elect disciples' sake. Comfort us in thy mercy, for thy holy name's sake.
Rejoice, O thou that is dear for us, the very light of righteousness, even Christ.
chosen pure peace for us, O Lord, that you may have mercy upon our souls and forgive us our sins. Rejoice, O Virgin Mary, parent of God, holy and pure. Very pleader for the race of mankind. Plead for us before Christ, thy Son, that you may avoid sinful remission of our sins. Rejoice, O Virgin pure, Mary Queen. Rejoice, O pride of our kind. Rejoice, O Lord, that bears us, Emmanuel, our God. We ask you to remember us, O to be our chief, our Lord Jesus Christ, that you may have mercy upon our souls and forgive us our sins.
This is a time of blessing, this is a time of chosen incense, the time of praise of our Savior, love of man Christ.
Mary's incense and the incense is here, because he was a woman more fragrant than all incense, who she bear, him and save us.
The fragrant ointment of Jesus Christ, so come let us worship him and keep his commandment, that he may forgive us our sins.
To Michael was given mercy and glad thanks to Gabriel, every gift to the Virgin Mary.
To David was given understanding and wisdom to Solomon, and a horn of oil to Samuel, for he was the anointed of
kings. To our father Peter was given the keys and virginity to John, and the apostleship to our father Paul, for he was the light of the church.
And ointment is Mary, for he that was in the womb who is more fragrant than all incense.
In Mary Virgin, pure the Father was well pleased, I decked the tabernacle and fabrication of beloved Son.
Moses was given the law and priesthood to Aaron, to Zacharias the priest was given the chosen incense.
They made the tabernacle of the testimony, appoint the wood of God, and Aaron the priest in the midst thereof made the chosen incense to go up.
Serve and worship him, and the cherubim praise him and cry, saying,
Holy, holy, holy is the Lord
among the thousands, and honored among the tens of thousands. Thou art the incense, our Savior, for thou didst come and saved us. Have mercy upon us.
Fall into sin, but vindicate us against our enemies, our accusers,
Grant us continuous spread of beauty, get from being swallowed up by the enemy. O eternal King, hear, comfort the widows, accept the orphans, pray by your plead to thy mercy. Grant wisdom to the foolish, restore the lost, save the prisoners, and be a refuge to all of us, for thine is the blessed kingdom, O Lord our God.
Thank you.
Give ear, O Shepherd of Israel, thou that leadest Joseph like a flock, thou that dwellest between the cherubim, shine forth before Ephraim and Benjamin and Manasseh. Stir up thy strength and come and save us. Hallelujah, stand up and hearken to the Holy Gospel. Bless it all, Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
And with thy Spirit,
the Holy Gospel, which just read the word of the Son of God.
Glory be to thee, Christ, my Lord and my God at all time. Sing aloud unto God our strength. Make a joyful noise unto the God of Jacob. Take a psalm and bring hither the timbrel, the pleasant harp with the psaltery.
Holy Gospel is taken from St. John chapter 10 from verse 1 to 21. St. John chapter 10 from verse 1 to 21. Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that entereth not by the door into the sheepfold, but climbeth up some other way, the same is a thief and a robber. But he that entereth in by the door is the shepherd of the sheep. To him the porter openeth, and the sheep hear his voice, and he calleth his own sheep by name, and leadeth them out. And when he putteth forth his own sheep, he goeth before them, and the sheep follow him, for they know his voice. And a stranger will they not follow, but will flee from him, for they know not the voice of strangers. This parable spake Jesus unto them, but they understood not what things they were which he spake unto them. Then said Jesus unto them again, verily, verily, I say unto you, I am the door of the sheep. All that ever came before me are thieves and robbers, but the sheep did not hear them. I am the door. By me, if any man enter in, he shall be saved, and shall go in and out and find pasture. The thief cometh not, but for to steal, and to kill, and to destroy. I am come that they might have life, and that they might have it more abundantly. I am the good shepherd giveth his life for the sheep. But he that is an hireling, and not a shepherd, whose own the sheep are not, seeth the wolf coming, and leaveth the sheep, and fleeth, and the wolf catcheth them, and scattereth the sheep. The hireling fleeth because he is an hireling and careth not for the sheep. I am the good shepherd and know my sheep and am known of mine. As the Father knoweth me, even so know I the Father. And I lay down my life for the sheep. Another sheep I have which are not of this fold, them also I must bring, and they shall hear my voice, and there shall be one fold and one shepherd. Therefore doth my Father love me, because I laid up my life that I might take it again. No man taketh it from me, but I lay it down of myself. I have power to lay it down, and I have power to take it again. This commandment have I received of my Father. There was a division therefore again among the Jews for these sayings. And many of them said, he hath a devil and is mad. Why hear ye him? Others said, these are not the words of him that hath a devil. Can the devil open the eyes of the blind? Resting on the 21st verse.
Amen. Page 85, Miss Paul, the J, and 376, and verse 16.
He that came even to the Son of everlasting life.
In the beginning was the Word, the Word was the Word of God, the Word was made flesh, and dwelt among us. And we beheld the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, the Word of the living Father, and the life of the Word, the Word of God. Flesh was not corrupted.
Glory be to thee, Lord God Almighty, who has made us meet to hear the word of thy Holy Gospel and read it.
Please set down to this right the will of thy holy gospel in our heart, and accept our prayers in thy temple way, O Lord, Jesus Christus, our Redeemer. Have said thy mercy and thy compassion upon us and upon thy people through thy only begotten Son, for thy is the glory and power world without end.
Page 87 and small, the G after the H and the big start last
time. Only one living forever, because
from all ages, Holy Virgin, thou hast seed of man, and grew like men, the elder thoughts in all immortal. Neither was thy confidence found. Then he suffered, died in flesh, rose from the dead on the third day, ascended unto heaven unto the Father who sent him. Sat on the right hand of power, sent to us the Paraclete, the Holy Spirit, who proceeded from the Father, and saved all the world, and who is co-eternal with the Father and the Son. We say further that all the creatures of God are good, and there is nothing to be rejected. And the Spirit, the life of the body, is pure and holy and all. And we say that marriage is pure and childhood is undefiled, because God created Adam and Eve to follow the man.
We understand further that there is in our body a soul, which is immortal and does not perish with the body. We repudiate all the rules of heretics and all schisms and transgressions of the law, because they are for us impure. We also believe in the resurrection of the dead, the righteous and sinners, and in the day of judgment, when everyone will become parents according to his deeds. We also believe that Christ is not in the least degree inferior because of his incarnation, but he is God, the Word, who truly became man and reconciled mankind to God, being the high priest of the Father. Henceforth, let us not be circumcised like the Jews.
We know that he was fulfilled the law and the prophets as already come. To him before whose coming all peoples of the power, Jesus Christ, who is descended from Judah, from the root of Jesse, whose government is upon his shoulder. To him be glory, thanksgiving, greatness, blessing, praise, all, both now and ever, and world without end.
He that is pure, let him receive of the oblation, and he that is not pure, let him not receive of it.
If there be any who disdain this word of the priest, or laugh or speak or stand in the church in an evil manner, let him know and understand that he is provoking to wrath our Lord Jesus Christ, and bringing upon himself the curse instead of a blessing, and will get from God the fire of hell instead of the remission of sin.
O my Lord and my God, what of the Lord, give of peace and love. Take away from me every evil thought, revenge, envy, and all the lusts of the flesh. Make me meet to be added to thy holy servants, who please thee by the preach of the light in the days of love and peace. Because it is thou that hast come down from heaven, and make peace between the inhabitants of heaven and the inhabitants of earth. And this gather together all thy people to glorify thee, for thine is the glory, world without end.
Truth to thee with him and with the Holy Spirit be glory and dominion.
Anaphora of the Lord, peace to King in the middle of this holy, the Anaphora of the Lord. From the book of Peter, which our Lord and our Savior Jesus Christ uttered to the apostles before his ascension to heaven and after his resurrection from the dead, the blessing of his grace and the name of his health, be to our patriarchs, Abuna Macorius and Abuna Matthias, and our blessed and our blessed Bishop Abuna Thaddeus, and with all our clergy and congregation forever.
Amen.
Lift up your heart from forever.
Yes, our hearts are in heaven. For thy name's sake, strengthen us and make us worthy, Jesus Christ, our Lord and our God.
If there is any who is quarreling with his neighbor, let him forgive him.
According to thy mercy, O God, and according to our sins.
According to thy mercy, O God, and not according to our sins.
According to thy mercy, O God, and not according to our sins.
If there is doubt in the heart of anyone, let him believe.
According to thy mercy, O God, and not according to our sins.
If there is any blemish in the heart of anyone, let him not approve.
According to thy mercy, O God, and not according to our sins.
If there is any who has fallen into sin, let him not forget it, because it must not be forgotten.
According to thy mercy, O God, and according to our sins.
If there is anyone who has a diseased conscience, let him not approve.
According to thy mercy, O God, and according to our sins.
If there is any who is an adulterer and is impure, let him be sent out.
According to thy mercy, O God, and according to our sins.
If there is any who is alienated from the commandments of Jesus, he shall be forbidden to come.
According to thy mercy, O God, and according to our sins.
If there is anyone who disdains the prophet, let him deliver himself from the wrath of the only begotten and save his soul. Let him not oppose the cross, but flee from the wrath of the Lord, because there are those who look upon us, namely the Father of Light, with his Son and his holy angels, who visit the church. Look at yourself and cleanse yourself, and do not make mention of your neighbor's sin. Be careful that no one should bear any wrath against his neighbor. God is looking. Lift up your heart. Let us come near the medicine of life. Let us receive the holiness which is granted unto us by grace through the wisdom of the Lord.
The Lord be with you all.
And with thy spirit.
Give thee thanks unto our God.
It is right, it is just.
Lift up your hands.
We have lifted them up unto the Lord, O God.
He is holy among the holy ones.
Always in heaven and on earth.
He is holy among the holy ones.
Always in heaven and on earth.
He is holy among the holy ones.
Always in heaven and on earth.
Holy, holy, holy God. And affirm of our Lord and our God and our Savior Jesus Christ, the blessing of his forgiveness with our clergy and our congregation forever.
Amen. Badachi no ibesumai vetnos, mengis the dimda, regard ibesumai the unish in whom Babin held you, the letter to the Zaria, the latch in the million, the yay of the
We give thee thanks, Holy God, the perfecter of our soul, and the hope of our life, the undefiled treasure. Father, of thy only begotten Son, our Savior, who declared thy will because thou hast desired that we should be saved through. Our hearts give thanks to thee, Lord. Thou art the strength of the Father, grace to the Gentiles, knowledge to the upright, wisdom to the sinner. Heal of the soul, exalt of the humble of our city. Thou art the staff of the righteous, the hope of the persecuted, the refuge of the sufferers. O light of the perfect Son of the living God, shine upon us with thy unfailing grace, granting us firmness, strength, faithfulness, wisdom, the power of faith which is immutable and the immutable hope. Grant, Lord, to our humility, spiritual insight, so that we, thy servants, may be truly pure, and all the people shall glorify thee.
We thank thee and glorify thee,
Lord. Page 99, in small of the day, and 43 of the text, and the
sit down, please.
Holy Trinity, Father, Son, Holy Spirit, bless thy people, Christians, beloved in blessing heavenly and earthly. And descend upon us, grateful Holy Spirit, and make joyful thy Holy Church, open unto us with mercy and in faith, and perfect unto us, grateful thy Holy Trinity, and our blessed birth. O my Lord Jesus Christ, visiting the sick of thy people,
Let us give thee,
being born from the virgin, so that he might fulfill thy will and suffered for your sake, who have trusted in him.
Remember us, Lord, in thy kingdom. Remember us, Lord, Master, in thy kingdom. Remember us, Lord, in thy kingdom. As thou didst remember the thief on the right hand, when thou wast on the tree of the holy cross.
He who has been given to suffering by his own will, suffered in order that he might heal the sick, strengthen those who are about to fall, find those who are outcast, give life to them, destroy them to break the bonds of Satan, fulfill his father's will, set down in hell, open the gates of life, enlighten the righteous, establish the law, remove the darkness, cause the children to grow and make known his resurrection. In the same night in which they betrayed him,
raise up your hand.
He took bread and his holy blessings, spotless hand.
We believe that this is he, truly believe.
Gave thanks, the blessing broke, and gave it to his disciples, saying unto them, Faith, eat, this bread is my body which will be broken for you for the forgiveness of sin.
Amen.
When you do this, do it in remembrance of me, and likewise also the cup putting wine into it, giving thanks, a blessing, hallowing thou givest to them. Truly, this is thy blood which has been shed for us.
Amen, amen, amen. We believe and confess, we praise thee, our Lord and our God, that this is he we truly believe.
Now, Lord, remember in thy death and resurrection, we believe in thee. We offer thee this bread and this cup, giving thanks unto thee alone. O God, the Savior of the world, because thou didst order us to stand before thee and to serve thee. For this reason, we thy servants glorify thee, O Lord.
For this reason, we thy servants glorify thee, O Lord.
Lord, we pray and beseech you to send the Holy Spirit and power upon this bread and upon this cup to make them the body and blood of our Lord and our Savior Jesus Christ forever. Again we offer unto thee this thanksgiving, eternal Trinity, Lord the Father of Jesus Christ, whom every creature and soul fear, and the fear enters into the soul. This thanksgiving is fitted unto thee. We have not offered unto thy holiness meat or drink. Suffer them not to be forward judgment on occasion of reproach by the enemy, or forward destruction, but health of our flesh and strength of our spirit. Yea, Lord, our God, grant us for the sake of thy great name to flee from all thoughts which displease thee. Lord, grant us that the counsel of death may depart from us. We who are written to thy name within the veil of thy sanctuary in the highest heaven, let death hear thy name and be troubled. Let the death speak of the sun and heaven be shut down. Let the spirit of destruction tremble and the serpent be removed. Let unbelief depart and the criminal be destroyed. Let anger be still and envy come to nothing, and let him who continually sins be rebuked. Let those who love money be cast out, let infirmity be removed, let the liar be cast out, and let all poisonous creatures be scattered. Lord, grant them a light in the eyes of our hearts, so that they may see, thank and glorify thee. Remember in thee and serve in thee, because thou only art their portion. O Son and Mother of God, served by all creatures, make perfect and strengthen the grace which thou hast revealed to them, and keep those who have the grace of health. Make straight that faith which those who praise thee with the strength of the tongue learn by the exercise of the tongue. Save those who always fulfill thy will. Visit the widow. Accept those who have gone to the rest in faith. Grant us, Lord, a portion with all saints. Grant us power to please thee as they have pleased thee.
With all the heart, let us beseech the Lord our God that he grant unto us the good communion of the Holy Spirit.
As it was, is, and shall be unto generation of generation, world without end.
Be thy people in truth and holiness. Grant, Lord, mercy unto us to receive of thy mystery that we may be truly satisfied with the Holy Spirit. Grant power and strength.
grant us to be united through thy Holy Spirit, and heal us by this oblation, that we may live in thee forever.
Blessed be the name of the Lord, and blessed be he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Let the name of his glory be blessed, so be it, so be it, so be it blessed.
Blessed be the name of the Lord, and blessed be he that cometh in the name of the Lord. And let the name of his glory be blessed, so be it, so be it, so be it blessed.
Send upon me the Spirit of righteousness.
Send upon us the grace of the Holy Spirit.
Daughter
rock, and upon this rock I will build my holy church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. And unto thee I give the keys of the kingdom of heaven. What thou hast bound on earth shall be bound in heaven, and what thou hast loosed on earth shall be loosed in heaven. Let all thy servants and thy handmaids, according to their several names, be observant and set free out of the mouth of the Holy Spirit, and out of the mouth of thee also thy sinful and guilty servant, whether they are brought wittingly or unwittingly. Keep them, Lord, and defend them, thy servants, my father's brothers and sisters, and also loose me, thy humble and sinful servant, and observe them and set them free out of the mouth of the Holy Trinity, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, and out of the mouth of me, thy sinful and unrighteous servant. O pitiful, merciful, and love of man, Lord our God, that takest away the sin of the world, accept the penitence of thy servants and thy handmaids, and shine upon them with the light of everlasting life. And forgive them, Lord, all their sins, for thou art good and the love of man. O Lord, our God, merciful, slow to anger, plenteous in mercy and righteous, forgive me my sins, and deliver all thy servants and handmaids from all transgression and curse. If we have transgressed against thee, Lord, whether in our word or in our deed or in our thought, release, remit, pardon, and have mercy, for thou art good and the love of man, Lord, our God. O Lord, observe us and set us free, and observe all thy people, and observe me, thy sinful servant.
O Lord, observe me.
May God observe you and observe thy sinful servant.
Remember, Lord, our honorable fathers, our patriarchs, Abunam of Glorious and Abunam of Tyres, and the blessed and honorable Archbishop Abunam Thaddeus. Our God, keep them for us so many years and length of days in righteousness and peace. Remember, Lord, the government and people of Sudan, the Bacon of Ethiopia and of the world. Remember, Lord, the patriarchs, archbishops, bishops, priests and deacons, anagnos and singers, virgins and monks, widows and orphans, men and women, aged and children, and all Christian people that are assembled in this holy church, and those that are here in this broadcast. Strengthen them in the faith of Christ. Remember, Lord, all our fathers, brothers and sisters that are asleep and resting out of the dark faith. Our fathers, Abuna Apollos, Abuna Gabriel, Abuna Georgius, Abuna Springer, Deacon Lucas Gill, Amayesos Joseph, and our brothers, Michael Francis, Heidi Georgius, Holden Dalva, Gabriesos Tekes, Selassie Greenwich, Heidi Esos Christopher, Fekre Esos Richards, and our sisters, Tito Dean, Samrita Selassie Absalom, Erita Miriam Neswick, Willita Gidan Chums, Pekirte Amna, and all our brothers and sisters that are resting in this time, and lay their souls in the bosom of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And as for us, deliver us from every transgression and curse, and from all wickedness, and from all rebellion, and from all false swearing, and from all anathemas, and from all perjury, and from mingling with heretics and Gentiles in error and defilement. Grant us, Lord, wisdom and power and reason, understanding and knowledge, that we may depart and flee forevermore from all works of Satan the tempter. Grant us, Lord, to do thy will and thy good pleasure at all times, and write our names in the book of life in the kingdom of heaven with all saints and martyrs, to Jesus Christ our Lord, through whom to thee with him and with the Holy Spirit be glory and dominion, both now and ever, and world without end.
Amen. Give me
holy things for the holy.
One is the Holy Father, one is the Holy Son, one is the Holy Spirit.
The Lord be with you all.
And with thy Spirit.
Oh,
Very confessed with a good testimony in the days of Pontius Pilate, And this body gave up our sins and for the life of our soul.
Archbishop Devman's attendants, Matthias and the Fiji, and Peter, and all our brothers and sisters who are participating from your respect. Today, in our church, we celebrate the Sunday of Nwane, or the Good Shepherd. As the lessons have guided us, especially of the psalm, the theme following from the psalm is about a prophecy of the incarnation and the changes that it would bring about. The incarnation is Christ coming into the world, the Good Shepherd. Christ would reveal himself, Psalm tells us, in the incarnation for a specific purpose of our salvation and to establish his vineyard. The vineyard of Christ is the church. This vineyard would consist of those who are changed through conversion. They are converted to him and who are saved from the devil. And this is the spirituality within the psalm, and that theme points to all the lessons that we read, culminated in the gospel. This gospel was a warfare gospel. And we are within time of spiritual warfare. It was the last year of Jesus, the Good Shepherd's life on earth, and he went up to Jerusalem for one of the three major feasts, the Feast of Tabernacles. And the Pharisees and the scribes had sent to arrest him. It was an eight-day feast. The Feast of Tabernacles was the feast when the Jews were in Sinai. They lived in tents or tabernacles. And on the last day, those who were sent to arrest him were converted. And John tells us, they found nothing. They couldn't arrest him and bring him. The Pharisees called them by name in the gospel. But this parable Jesus used of the Good Shepherd is a parable of leadership. It is Christ versus the Pharisees. The Pharisees was elected and chosen or ordained to be the pastors or the shepherd of the people. Mankind has gone through human development. First, he has his conscience and his nature by which he lives. Within history, God came to help man, take him to another level, and give him the law of Moses. So he had a law of nature and conscience. Then he had the law of Moses. And these leaders became corrupt. And this parable, Christ showed them up as the kind of leaders they were. They were full of deceit. Their lives and leadership was marked by deceit, by pride, and they lacked compassion. They did not care about the people. Jesus is the good shepherd, not just the shepherd, but the good shepherd. He is merciful, he is compassionate, and he has all virtues. Feeding, tending the lambs, feeding the sheep, caring for the sheep. This is the only commission he gave. At the end of his ministry, he said, tend my lambs. Feed my lambs, feed my sheep. That's the duty of the pastor. and he confronts the issue here by telling them he's not only the pastor, but he's also the door. We have to understand what the scripture means by door. The door in scripture is God's word. And it means both the scriptures and the Lord himself. St. John chapter 7 verse tells us. The incarnation of Christ, the word of God, is prefigured in the Old Testament over 300 times, pointing to him and his incarnation. One who leads, Christ said, must lead in a way that is not according to the scribes and Pharisees. For the righteousness must exceed the righteousness of the scribes and Pharisees. They must lead according to Christ, according to the scriptures and what they teach. Not to do that is to be a thief and a robber. And the chief of them is Satan, who ultimately destroys and destroys life. And this is the warfare in which the world comes. The warfare with Satan. The pastor must lead according, Christ said, to his way, his truth, that can lead the sheep to eternal life. It is in this context that he, presenting himself as the good shepherd, he has ultimate knowledge of everyone. A pastor in the church must know his sheep by name. The big and the small, he must care for the sheep. He must visit the sheep. He must be the door of the sheep, teaching them the scriptures, teaching them the way to salvation. In return, the people will respond to the true leader, to the true pastor, and follow him. And in this Feast of Tabernacles, on this day, they remember the wilderness of Sinai. It was a bitter time. Bitter time for them. What happened is that, according to John 10:10, the ultimate thief is Satan, who spreads lies and heresies among the people of God, luring them, both leaders and people. And as the good shepherd, Christ enters by the door, fulfilling the scriptures concerning himself. He alone knows the Father, and the Father knows him. He knows the people personally. He knows everyone by name. Not even the hair of our head is lost in his sight. Everyone. Billions of people in the world. He knows each one by name. He gives life. He doesn't only give life, but he first gave his life for the sake of his sheep. He is the good pastor. He is the shepherd for the Gentiles and the Jew. There is only one shepherd. And when he comes, there will only be one flock. This good shepherd laid down his life for us, and we ought to lay down our lives for him by following him and for the sake of each other. We got to love our neighbor and we love ourselves. The shepherd of Israel, Isaiah said, is Christ in Isaiah 53. The shepherd of Israel is now the shepherd of the whole world also, Isaiah tells us. He himself said in 1 John, in John's Gospel chapter 1, the Lamb of God takes away the sins of the world. John the Baptist, when he saw it. Before the Lamb of God takes away the sins of the world. What does that mean? Man's enemy from the beginning were two things. man had two enemies, death and decay in the grave, and Satan. Those are the enemies. The good shepherd has come, and the good shepherd has confronted Satan using his most powerful weapon to destroy him. And this is the power of the good shepherd. That's why no one before him could have done it. Everyone said that was able to defeat, even Moses. But Christ came and he used the Satan's most powerful weapon and defeated him with it. The weapon of death. And he confronted it. He said, come on, he brought it on, died, and overcome death with his death, and brought us salvation. And he asked us during this chapter to understand the fullness of the heart, not only of his heart, but the heart of his mother. For he came into this world. He is, and we have to understand who he is. He is eternal in that he has a divine will. He is one with the Father. When Satan tried at him, he said, he did not. All the responses Christ gave to Satan in the 40 days of the temptation, after his fasting in the desert, were from Deuteronomy. And they pointed to one thing spiritually, to obedience and loyalty to God. Adam had moved away. The first sin is disobedience. Said Adam had moved away from obedience and moved away from loyalty and alert himself to sin. In the temptation, Christ stood up in obedience and loyalty to God, he and the Father. And that precedes our 40-day fast before the Holy Week, Lent. It precedes also, it brings us now to this 40-day fast we are having. We are called to understand the way of the shepherd in coming to loyalty and obedience to God. The good shepherd. Apart from being divine, terms of being one with God and having that will of oneness, also took from us through his mother the human will. He took our flesh. Was this is the power of the incarnation. That's why the word before his incarnation is this position. Only the good flesh of his mother. And that same flesh we eat and drink. That flesh he took on the mother was not a divine flesh, but a divine will. It was human will. It was our will. And the good shepherd taught us how to subject the human will to the divine will. Even at the ultimate end at Gethsemane, when the two wills were confronted, and the human will couldn't take the pressure of the forces of the temptation, he said, let it pass, but he said, yet, not my will, not the human will, but the divine will. And this is the essence of Christ, the good shepherd, teaching us. We have to come to understand, we have to subject our will to God's will. And he is the way, he is the truth, he is the life. That's why no other. All others. Today the church calls us to follow that, to understand the spirituality of that. More than that, in this time of warfare, spiritual warfare, we cannot, with our reason, our intellect, the genius of science, the genius of medicine, we can't even withstand the beginning of sorrows. What we are facing now as a pandemic is only the beginning of sorrows, and it has crushed all of man's intelligence and power and authority. We cannot depend on our will and our nature and our knowledge to stand before us. We are to subject ourselves to the divine will. And how are we to do that? To become one with God. We have to have an intimate relationship with God, like His mother. Her will became one with the will of God. Thy will be done. Only His will was done in the life. And He gave us that, good shepherd gave us the opportunity to become intimate with Him by giving us His own flesh and blood. The church today has the power of the consecrated place. The power of the consecration of the church and the power of being consecrated in Christ through baptism. And the people cannot be left out there, helpless and caring without caring, to face the forces of it. The good shepherd gave Him His life. He asked us to tend His lamb, to feed His lamb, to feed His sheep. Not with our understanding, but with His flesh and blood. And the people of God. It is the only hope for the people to survive in this warfare. And if He gave His life for us, then we ought to give our lives to feed. We can't remain in our own survival, in our own protection. We've got to go out and feed the people. May the example of the good shepherd take root in our lives. And may we follow Him. For He is the way. He is the truth. He is the life. Whether we are afraid to die, or we are not afraid to die, still we will die. Lose our lives in saving life. But if we try to save our lives, we will lose. The theme of the psalm points us forward to the example of Scripture. Let us follow the words of Scripture. Just an hour.
Sancta Benediction, page 125 and small pages.
O eternal God, light of life, and for children of God, thy servant of thy hands, and plant in the hand of thy men, holding on the difference of the earth, and count in the earth, those who are being used by God and thy breath. And let thy hand rest upon the earth and have bondage before thee, thy people, men and women, aged and children, virgins and bonds, widows and orphans, and join us also with them, for the earth and suffer, and starving and strengthen us with them for thy archangels and from all the works that have passed, and in all good works denied us through thy own begotten Son, through whom to be with them of Holy Spirit.
Servant the Archbishop.
O Lord, serve thy people
Sometimes it's difficult But behind every dark cloud, there's a silver lining. And we have to hope that God continues to keep us until we meet totally together. So may God bless you.
Sevat leksiyami emesemayat, Sevat leksiyami emesemayat, Veselam bemer.